Hi and welcome to Qlik Fix. This video will demonstrate how the Windows Authentication Pattern setting in Qlik Sense Virtual Proxy Authentication configuration enables either Integrated Windows Authentication or Form-based Authentication. With Integrated Windows Authentication, NTLM is used to authenticate the user automatically, or by prompting the user for credentials depending on the current system internet options as shown here. This happens because the default Windows Authentication Pattern value, Windows, is present in the HTTP User Agent Request header submitted by all major web browsers when communicating with QlikSense. If there is no match, form-based authentication is used in which a login page is presented to the client when accessing the hub or QMC. Here we use the browser's developer tools to visualize the user agent headers sent to the QlikSense when using Google Chrome, Internet Explorer, Microsoft Edge, and Firefox. Notice that they all include similar as well as distinct content in this header. The value configured in the virtual proxy configuration is checked against this header for a match. In this case, we see the word Windows is present in all user agent headers, so integrated authentication using NTLM is used. Enabling form-based authentication is useful in certain scenarios, such as when the browser does not automatically authenticate, neither prompts the client for credentials due to an environmental restriction. As a form-based authentication example, we have created a new virtual proxy configured with the string EDG in the Windows Authentication Pattern field. Now, when using the virtual proxy, we can see that integrated Windows Authentication is only used with the Microsoft Edge browser. Using Internet Explorer or any other browser leads to the web form login page as seen here. Note, however, that in both cases, Windows Authentication is performed in the backend, and a ticket is obtained by the default Windows Authentication module, since the Authentication module redirect URI field is left blank. If you would like more information, search for answers using the Unified Search tool on the support portal. It searches across the support knowledge base, Qlik community, Qlik help site, and Qlik YouTube channels. Take advantage of the expertise of peers, product experts, and technical support engineers by asking a question in Qlik product forums on Qlik community. And don't forget to subscribe to the support update blog. Thanks for watching. Nailed it.